Hello students, welcome back again. Okay, we will be taking up the third problem in relative velocity method. This is a different type of problem wherein you can see in the diagram, it's a 4-bar chain. Okay, there is another link attached to the second link BC, that is BEC or BCE. Okay, is the another link attached to it. So here we need to find out the velocity and acceleration of point E. So this is also important problem as far as your examination is concerned or any competitive examinations. So Chibal or in the question paper, they will ask to find out the velocity and acceleration of the point E on another link. Okay, so let us read out the problem first. In a 4-bar mechanism, ABCD, AD is fixed. So AD is the fixed link or the frame and it is 100 millimeter. So the dimensions are given for all the links. Long, the crank AB, so crank is here, AB. It is 45 millimeter long and rotates at 200 RPM. So speed is given, N is equal to 200 RPM, NAB is equal to 200 RPM clockwise. While the line AB or the crank length is 45 millimeter, BC is 70 millimeter, CD is 70 millimeter, BE is 40 millimeter, okay, and CE is 45 millimeter. And angle BAD is equal to 60 degree. So now refer this diagram and find velocity and acceleration of point E. Also find the velocities and acceleration of the remaining links. So as we progress in the problem, automatically we will be finding out the velocities and accelerations for all the links, correct? So no need to worry about that. So it is better that, so when we draw the velocity diagram, find out all the velocities. When we draw the acceleration diagram, find out all the accelerations, that is, so radial acceleration will be found out before drawing the acceleration diagram itself. After drawing the acceleration diagram, draw the or find out the tangential acceleration also. Okay, and also find alpha related to that tangential acceleration or that related to that link. Okay, so now let us start with the problem. This is the given diagram. So very first step is take down the data given. So NAB is equal to 200 RPM, AB 45, BC 70, CD 70, BE 40, all of them in millimeter only. So after, and C is equal to 45 millimeter, AD 100 millimeter, angle BAD is equal to 60 degree. Now draw the configuration diagram for this. Configuration diagram, as I have told you earlier also, okay, take any scale you want, okay, and just continue with it and draw the configuration diagram. Okay, so first draw AD, which is fixed, then measure 60 degree and draw the crank AB, then measure BC, cut an arc, measure DC, cut an arc, and finally join BC also. BE and CE both are given. BE and CE dimensions are given. So measure them, cut arc using the compass, okay, and mark the point and join the two lines and hatch it. So all the dimensions should be written here. Whatever the dimensions you have taken in order to represent the configuration diagram should be written here. So once it is done, it is our duty now to find out the velocity, at least one velocity, so that we can start with the velocity diagram. So here, as you people know, okay, velocity of B with respect to A can be found out because omega of B with respect to A can be found out. Okay, that can be found out because speed of rotation of the crank is given, that is 2 pi into 200 divided by 60. So the value which you obtain, okay, for omega BA is 20.94 radians per second. Okay, using this, you can find out the velocity of that particular link or velocity of B with respect to A. That is omega BA into link length BA or R. You can represent BA as or AB as R. So omega is 20.94 into the link length AB is 0.045 meters. So this will give you a value of 0.9 meter per second. So one, at least one Okay, velocity is sufficient to start the velocity diagram. Okay, so let us start with the velocity diagram. We know VBA, that is 0.9 meter per second. So therefore, this is the only known value to construct the velocity diagram. Therefore, we are going to take the scale with respect to this one only. Okay, so what we'll do is we'll consider 0.1 meter per second as 1 centimeter. Scale, let us take as 0.1 meter per second is equal to 1 centimeter, or 10 centimeter is equal to 1 meter per second. You can consider this like this also, no problem with that. Okay, so that will be equal to 9 centimeters. Now, we know BA. So always, so measure, first of all, mark the points or first write down the points, fixed points, okay, and mark a point. That is AD. So write down AD as fixed points. And now consider the link AB. So velocity vector acts perpendicular to this link. So draw a perpendicular line to this link for the measured value, that is 9 centimeters. Okay, now go to the second link, BC. So velocity vector for this link will act perpendicular to it. So take the set square, exactly perpendicular line you should draw here from B. Okay, from B you should draw an exactly perpendicular line. So we don't know the magnitude of it, correct? We don't know the magnitude. Therefore, draw to an unknown magnitude. Now consider another link, that is CD. And take your set square, draw exactly perpendicular line to this. Okay. From D, draw a line exactly perpendicular to the link CD. So this is the velocity diagram. Now you can represent the velocities over here. Okay, this is point B, this is A, B, C, and then D. So this is velocity of C with respect to D. This is velocity of B with respect to A. And this is velocity of C with respect to B. Now we have another link, and that has to be shown in the velocity diagram also. So consider now BE. Okay, the velocity vector acts exactly perpendicular to this particular link. So draw a perpendicular line from B. Okay, for unknown magnitude. For unknown magnitude. Okay, similarly, so okay, draw a perpendicular line from B to an unknown magnitude. Okay, now go back to the configuration diagram and consider CE. So the velocity acts exactly perpendicular to it. Now mark or draw a line perpendicular to that particular CE, line CE. So this is point E. This is point E. Now if you connect AB to E, you can find the velocity of E. You can find the velocity of E. Okay, so this is BBE, velocity of B with respect to E. Sorry, B, velocity of E with respect to B and velocity of E with respect to C. Now join AD to E and you can find out BE. Now measure BE, directly you can find out the value of the velocity of that point E. Okay, as given in the problem, we have to calculate or we have to measure or we have to calculate the velocity of that point E. Okay, so now the measure the velocities, all the velocities, and write down the velocities. So as you can see here, VBA is 0.9 meter per second. It has already been calculated. VCB, okay, this VCB is, this VCB is 0.8 meter per second. Then BCD. So 0.8, how 0.8? Okay, I'll clarify that dot also. So it will come around 8 centimeters. So this line C to B. Okay, it comes 8 centimeters. So we have taken a scale of 10 centimeters equal to 1 meter per second. So therefore, now divide it by 10. So that will be equal to 0.8 meter per second. So next, calculate VCD or measure VCD. So if you measure VCD, it will be around 2.2 divided by 10. So that will be 0.22 meter per second. Now measure VE, that is A to E or D to E. So it will be 7.2 divided by 10. That will be equal to 0.72 meter per second. So these are the velocity we have calculated using the velocity diagram. So this is half of the problem. This is half of the solution for the problem given. Now let us consider acceleration diagram. How to draw the acceleration diagram? Okay, you people already know. For each link, we have to consider or find out two of the acceleration components, that is radial acceleration component and tangential acceleration component. Now let us consider AB, link AB. So wherein you are going to calculate the radial component of acceleration as well as the tangential component of acceleration. So radial component of acceleration is given by BBA square divided by the link length BA or AB. So VBA has been calculated, that is 0.9 square divided by AB is 0.045. So when you calculate this, it will come around 18 meter per second square. One more thing, students, don't worry if you are solving the same problem and if you are getting different results. Okay, values may vary. Okay, approximately around 0.5, 0.6, or maybe one centimeter, values may vary. Okay, because you people may be having the set squares, I may be having the scale, I am doing it on an iPad, you people may be solving it on a paper. Okay, that differences arise. Okay, even student to student, the values may differ. Very, very minute differences may be there. So when you consider AB, the link AB, AT of BA is equal to zero because alpha is zero. So therefore, radial component of acceleration itself is the resultant acceleration. Now, consider second link BC, ARCB can be calculated using the formula V square CB divided by CB. VCB is 0.8. Substitute that and find out the value of ARCB. So that is 9.14 meter per second square. Now we have to find out the tangential acceleration of CB. Now let us consider another link CD. So wherein you need to find out both the components of acceleration. ARCD is equal to V square CD divided by CD. So VCD from the velocity diagram is 0.22 square. Okay, divided by CD, that is the link length is 0.07. So finally we obtain the value of 0.7 meter per second square. Okay, so now tangential component is unknown. We have to find it out using the acceleration diagram. Now let us consider this as, see, 18 meter per second square is the highest value which you have obtained. So that is why what I will do is I'll consider 1 centimeter is equal to 2 meter per second square. 1 centimeter is equal to 2 meter per second square. So what has this become? This has become 9 centimeters. This has become 4.56 centimeters. So and that has become 0.45 or equal to 0.5. Okay, 0.4 maybe. Now mark the points A dash, D dash. Mark the points A dash, D dash, because they are the, it is the fixed link. They are the points on the fixed link, correct? Now, consider the first link or the crank. Okay, the radial component of acceleration always acts parallel to it. So draw a parallel line to that link with a value of 9 centimeters, with a value of 9 centimeters. Okay, so this is represented as AR of BA, AR of BA, and it is equal to the resultant acceleration of B with respect to A. It is actually the resultant acceleration of B with respect to A. Now consider the second link BC. We have got two components. One is the radial component, another one is the tangential component. Radial component value is 4.56 centimeters. So the radial component acts parallel to the link. Okay, from the point B dash, measure 4.56 or 4.6 maybe, and draw a dotted line, which represents the radial component of acceleration. Which represents the radial component of acceleration. Let me take another color and show it to you. It will make you understand very clearly. Okay, the difference. Four point five or 4.6, let us say. Okay, now we have tangential component which acts exactly perpendicular to that or perpendicular to the link. Okay, it acts perpendicular to the radial component also, or it acts perpendicular to the link also. Okay, so now draw a perpendicular line of unknown magnitude. We do not know the magnitude of that, correct? So draw a perpendicular line for the unknown magnitude, but not going beyond a dash d dash. That is for sure. Okay, so this is represented as AR of BA. Sorry, BC, and this is represented as AT of BC. Okay, we don't have the resultant acceleration yet because we don't have the point C dash. So now consider the last link, that is CD. So using CD, you can draw the radial component as well as the tangential component. Radial component acts parallel to it. Draw a line of 0.4 centimeter. I'll select another color and I'll show you. 0.4 centimeter, draw a line. Okay, exactly parallel to the link. So that will be your radial component, that is AR of CD. AR of CD. Now draw the tangential component, that is perpendicular to the link or perpendicular to the line drawn. Okay, already in the acceleration diagram. So this will intersect AT of BC at some particular point, correct? This will intersect AT of BC at some particular point. Name that point as C dash. Name that point as C dash. So all the points have been obtained, that is A dash, B dash, C dash, as well as D dash. So this is the tangential acceleration. So this is C dash. So when you connect D dash to C dash, you will get the resultant acceleration of CD. Connect C dash and D dash, you will get the resultant acceleration of CD. Now connect B dash to C dash and get the resultant acceleration of BC. So this is the resultant acceleration and directions I have explained in the last problem itself. So as the radial component and tangential component are in the same direction, the resultant component will be, or the resultant acceleration will be in the opposite direction. So similarly, join B dash C dash and obtain the resultant acceleration for BC. So yeah, represent it like this. Now we need to find the acceleration for the point E. For that, again, I'll use, in the theory I have explained about this, and in the last problem also I have explained about this, how to locate a point on the link. So this is the logic or principle of similarity triangles, similar triangles. So B dash C dash, okay, see, this is B dash C dash divided by the original link length BC is equal to B dash E dash. We need to find out that point B dash E dash, or the distance from B dash to E dash. It has to be found out, B dash E dash divided by BE, divided by BE, the original link length. So that is equal to C dash E dash. Otherwise, you can use this relation also. C dash E dash, that is C dash to E dash, the distance between C dash and E dash, divided by CE, divided by CE. Okay, so now let us take the values. So B dash C dash, you can measure here. So this particular line, that is the resultant acceleration of BC, can be measured, okay, like this. So B dash C dash by BC is equal to B dash E dash by BE. Let us consider this. So B dash E dash, we have to find out, is equal to BE into B dash C dash divided by the link length BC. The link length BC. So therefore, that is equal to link length is 40 into B dash C dash is 5.6 divided by BC is 70. So that is almost equal to 3.2 centimeters. Okay. Similarly, you can find out, okay, B dash E dash. You need to find out C dash E dash also, correct? Because the point is not lying on this line. Okay. The point is lying somewhere away from this line. So you need to find out B dash E dash and C dash E dash also. So C dash E dash, B dash E dash divided by B is equal to C dash E dash divided by CE. So C dash E dash can be found out by cross multiplying CE into B dash E dash divided by BE. So that is 3.2 into 45 divided by 40. So that will be around 3.6. So now measure 3.6 from C dash, cut an arc. Measure 3.2 from B dash and cut an arc. Now join both the lines. Okay, there will be an arc formed here, somewhere here. So now join the point and you can get E. Point E. So now join B dash E dash and C dash E dash also. Okay, so this is point E. Now you can calculate or measure AE. Okay, you can measure AE, that is join A to E, join A dash to E dash. So you can get AE and you can just measure it. It will come around 7.8 and you have to multiply it with by 2 because we have selected 2 meter per second square is equal to 1 centimeter. So this will give you 15.6 meter per second square. Now measure AT of CB. So that is 3.4 into 2 will give you 6.8 meter per second square. Now using this value, you can calculate alpha CB, that is AT of CB divided by CB, that is equal to 6.8 divided by the link length 0.07. So that will give you the answer as 97.14 radians per second square. So similarly, you can measure AT of CD also. Measure AT of CD using the acceleration diagram. So when you measure that, it will come around 4.5 centimeters into 2. So that will give you 9 meter per second square. So therefore, alpha CD is equal to AT CD divided by the link length CD. Okay, that is equal to 9 divided by 0.07. So using calculator, find the value. So that is 128.57 radians per second square. Okay, students, this is how you need to solve, okay, these types of problems. Okay, so that's all for now. We will take up a toggle mechanism and we'll discuss, okay, or I'll teach you how to do the velocity and acceleration analysis of a toggle mechanism using relative velocity method. Okay, till then, stay safe. Bye.